would not have chosen this life, but here it is.
There's clearly something going on here. I know what he's got. We should test for Fragile X.
He's compulsive about tucking in tissues, closing doors. There are tantrums, there are meltdowns.
Then of course the tears start to come, and the why him and the why me.
Certainly not my child will be retarded.
This could happen to anybody.
Andy was actually an easy baby. He would sleep a lot and he wasn't terribly active.
I used to bring up to the pediatrician, he doesn't have that nice tight baby death grip on your finger when they hold on and they start to interact with you a little bit. And the pediatrician would always say, don't worry about it.
It became more and more obvious from the time he was about 6 months to the time he was 18 months that things were just not coming along.
The way his eyes are moving rapidly back and forth, that was the thing that the doctor really
Jumped on.
Petter was falling behind all developmental milestones. And we had a very supportive doctor who finally said, it's really time to ask the difficult question.
It was confusing. I'd never heard of Fragile X. I think like everybody, the first thing out of my mouth was fragile what?
Getting the diagnosis was the worst news I had imagined in all of my imaginings.
You're numb. There's just a numbness and an overwhelming fear of the future.
What is this going to mean for our child?
And, you know, there's a humility that comes with having a child with a disability that you adopt fairly quickly.
Making that silly face. Oh, that's not nice.
We actually view Fragile X as a disorder of excess.
It causes developmental delay. It causes physical symptoms like large ears and prominent forehead, flexible joints.
Learning disabilities, developmental delays, sensory issues.
Self-injurious behavior. I mean, every symptom in the book.
Patrick is obsessive compulsive. He's also compulsive about his schedule. And if anything that's on his schedule doesn't play according to plan, you're in big trouble.
And when somebody has that many different problems, you give them one drug for one thing and you make something else worse.
He has a developmental disorder, and then the seizure disorder makes that worse, and then the treatment for the seizure disorder makes it even worse again. And we see a lot of disruptive behaviors that make normal life pretty much impossible.
Now I need a big open. Come on, open up for Daddy. You have to be a good boy.
When you have a child with Fragile X, there's a lot of concessions you have to make. One of the things is just letting go of a lot of your assumptions and a lot of your hopes on who your child is going to be and who you will be as a parent with your child's experience and with his developments.
When you have a little baby, he's full of potential, and you just think, oh, he's going to be the all-American boy, and he'll go off to college, and, you know, he'll be a star athlete and a Rhodes Scholar, and that'll be wonderful. And so that comes crashing down very quickly.
His first kiss or drinking a beer for the first time or any of those things, I wonder if he's ever going to have those things.
I still drive by a ball field and look wistfully, or I see teenagers on a date and I think, how is that ever going to happen? Who is he going to be with?
All these dreams and aspirations you have, well, you kind of go, well, they're all gone. I mean, they're just wiped away. And you just start again. I still have hopes and dreams for him. They're just not as lofty as they once were.
Really, the story began several years ago by really a chance discovery in the lab that gave us reason to believe that we might be able to correct Fragile X syndrome.
Hi, Kian.
It's amazing to me that someone that may not necessarily have that personal tie can have such dedication to finding some sort of answer.
It's like driving a car with no brakes. You can't function normally. This turns out to be an incredibly exciting discovery, not just because maybe we've gained some insight into Fragile X. It's at least possible in principle to imagine correcting Fragile X.
We see a way out. We see a light at the end of the tunnel.
A treatment that'll help our kids is almost in our hands.
Perfect.
We're extremely optimistic that we're going to be able to provide some new therapies in Fragile X.
It's the scientists, and you think, wow, you know, they are committing their life's work to finding a cure for Fragile X. And so I see them like wizards, tinkering with the very basic chemistry of life.
In my own lab, I feel that we're making discoveries that are relevant not only to understanding and possibly correcting Fragile X, but also autism. Maybe 10 years ago, we wouldn't even dare dream that we would in our lifetimes. But actually, what we're doing now will have an impact in our scientific lifetime.
And I just think what Dr. Baer and his colleagues have been doing in the field of Fragile X research is just remarkable and heartening, gives us hope.
What's been, I think, just astonishing, honestly, is that in the fly and in the fish and in the mouse, we've been able to correct Fragile X. I don't know of any better case that could be made for a rational drug treatment for Fragile X. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than this. I think we're just at the beginning, and maybe Fragile X will be the first real success story. I hope it is.
FRAXA funds research aimed at finding a treatment for Fragile X.
We could change the life of these children and for their families.
There are so many people who work in the service of children like this and who are just angels, you know? And you're just so grateful that people are there being advocates for your child.
It helps a great deal knowing that there are people out there taking the interest and dedicating their life to really working towards a cure. It's incredible.
I know in Patrick's life there will be some form of intervention that will really get at the root causes of Fragile X and help his life.
The way I always think of Andy is on his best days is absolutely delightful. Everything's there. He can learn. He can love. He can talk. He can share. He can joke.
If he could be the same person, just be able to interact more, that would be like the dream come true.
Patrick is a generous, thoughtful, funny, kind, and intelligent person on his own terms.
The love I get from this little guy, I tell you, I don't know if it's Fragile X or what it is, but it's worth $1 billion because it's awesome.
I'm not going to give up on him. He's my life.